very simple based on conversions and initially how to kind of get the traffic to convert very well for you. Initially, a lot of people overcomplicate this process, and what I'm gonna do today is show you how to not overcomplicate this whole process. A lot of people tend to do that, but it's a very simple strategy. And not only that, I'm gonna go over what values these price point people buy every single time. So initially, number one thing that everyone needs is traffic regardless, right? What is traffic? Traffic is initially people eyeballs. So what you need in that case scenario is you need people eyes. So basically you need people eyes. That's what you need looking at your website, right? So that's simple, stupid simple. Nothing complicated whatsoever about that, all right? The thing that gets people is getting traffic, number one. Second thing is converting the traffic, because it's one thing to get the traffic, but it's a whole nother thing to convert the traffic. So a lot of people tend to have a problem with when you're trying to promote an offer or a service or something of that nature, but therefore you cannot convert the traffic. So that's what I'm going to go in detail more of right now. Right, so converting the traffic is tend to be a simple thing of, you know, understanding the numbers, understanding your conversion rate, understanding things of that nature, because that's what's going to initially push people above the edge and over to buy and sign up or get whatever offer or something you're promoting there. All right. Also, if you're watching this, I'm going to keep an eye on the chat right quick. Put it up on my laptop about that right here. Okay. So, this is going to be a little detailed, a little long today, kind of unexpected, but I felt like, you know, this is something I wanted to give out to you guys also, is some value on initially converting traffic and how to generate your traffic and how to keep it inside your business for a long period of time here. So I'm going to plug up into my laptop and stuff here. Here's me and Boyd. So the whole goal of having an internet-based business is you don't want it for the short term. You want it for the long term. And, you know, doing a lot of these things, I could say, will end your business for the short term. But there is a strategic ladder that you can follow to keep cash flow, to keep traffic in continuously on a long-term basis. All right. Keep cash flow and keep traffic coming in on a long-term basis, because that's initially what you want for you, yourself, your business, and things of that nature. You don't want anything temporarily. You don't want anything to stop that traffic. You don't want to go through the offers dying, and you don't want to go through, you know, issues like that a lot of the times. So that's what I'm kind of going to try to coach over today, is initially traffic and how to keep that traffic coming in for a long period of time. Not only how to keep it coming in for a long period of time, like what kind of offers should you work with to have, you know, what kind of offers should or networks you should work with to have to make sure that you're going to get paid continuously week after week or month after month when promoting those offers there. All right. Also, if you have any questions, I'm looking at the group chat now. Hey, what's going on, Jeremiah? Thanks for sharing. No problem, man. It's completely free. You know, if you have any questions, be sure to ask me and things of that nature. Also, just gonna do something completely free here for you guys. Simple strategy. It's not even a strategy, just understanding marketing and advertising, which a lot of people fail to realize and understand, all right? So traffic, that's the number one thing that you need, right? That's the thing that everyone stresses, is this thing right here, traffic. Everyone stresses that. That's a big key factor. So I want you to think in mind, frame of mind, let's say you have 1,000 unique hits, all right? So let's say 1,000 unique visitors, all right? So 1,000 unique, all right? So initially what we're gonna do is initially we're gonna say, hey, we want 1,000 unique visitors and we want to convert that in for sales or conversions. Conversions, AKA, is just a marketing term for sales, meaning someone is taking action on something that you have or that you're doing or something of that nature. That's all that really is. It's just, you know, a marketing term for sales. Now, also, if you guys are new to business, realize that marketing and sales is a major key factor inside every major business. Like, don't think, you know, I'm going to try to make a whole lot of money by promoting this offer and sending traffic to it, things of that nature. Really think on a business mindset, right? And that's another way how you keep your business going for the long term. It might not work as you want it to work at first, but you got to think long term, not short term, okay? So think of unique visitors, right? Second thing, what you want to do is you probably want to send them to a lender, right? So lender, everyone already knows this funnel, landing page. Alright, so everyone already knew this funnel here. It's nothing new that I say in here. So let's say from that landing page initially, we send traffic from you know our traffic source to the landing page. Let's say we get a 45% conversion rate, right? A click through rate. So that means we're gonna have 450 people, alright, click through. Alright? So that means we have 450 people that's actually taking interest in our offer, right? Now, I'm gonna put some numbers on how much all this costs too at the same time, and I'm gonna talk about also why you should ask your affiliate manager initially, what are you doing, and ask your affiliate manager, you know, how you do, what is this offer converting rate, you know, what's the conversion rate of the offer, things of that nature, what are other publishers, traffic sources for the offer, and things of that nature also. Alright, so initially we have 450 people that click through rate from our landing page onto our offer, right? So we got this amount of people going to our offer, click through rate to our offer, right? And so let's say our conversion rate is initially 2%, which is very low, but let's say our payout is initially $50. So I'm gonna put that up. I'm gonna put this down here, right? Payout equals $50, right? Conversion rate equals, let's say 2%, right? So that means 2 out of every 100 people is gonna buy our offer. Simple math. Everyone understands that, right? So that means 2 out of every 100 people is going to buy this product. So initially we've got 450 visitors. That means initially we're going to have 8, possibly 9 sales, right? So that means we'll have at least 8 to 9 conversions. All right, 8 to 9 CR, all right? Now, 8 to 9 CR, you're gonna multiply that times 50, right? So 50 times, you know, this is gonna equal like $450 or so, right? So what we're gonna earn is 450 payout. Simple, right? So 450 payout. Now, but we got to back out because we know how much we're gonna earn, but we got to then tally up how much it's gonna cost us. All this stuff right here, you can get all of these numbers right here before you even run the campaign, simply by asking your affiliate manager what the conversion rate of the offer, by asking what's the conversion rate of the offer and what's the payout of the offer. You can kind of, and then also what you can do is you can kind of ask other affiliates what's the landing page, CTR. CTR. Now, if you know those three things, right? The landing page, CTR, conversion rate, alpha payout, let's say you can kind of guess. And how are you going to get this number? Do you base it off other niches and multiple different industries and things of that nature? So, like, let's say I'm going to survey offers and my landing page click through rate is averaging like 30 something percent, right? Well, boom, that's the landing page, CTR. All right, and no matter what offer or whatever I'm promoting, that's the landing page CTR. I can get all this stuff right here before I even run anything. Before I even buy any traffic or spend any money on traffic, I can get all this information right here ahead of time. Second thing, what you would do is understand what's your traffic, what's, how much is it gonna cost you to get traffic, right? So, share on that. So, how much is gonna cost you to get traffic? That's the second thing that you gotta realize. That, in most case scenarios, could be, let's say, 10 cents a click, then we know exactly what we're doing. We're spending $100 and making $450. Now, let's say we're spending 50 cents a click, right? We're spending 50 cents a click, then our cost could be $200 or more than that, right? So that's what you got to realize also is that, you know, this right here is our unique visitors. So we're going to do, and multiply that times 0.50, right? And it won't matter. So it's going to cost us $500 to get 1,000 unique visitors. Our payout is going to be $450, so therefore, $500 costs. We're negative $50. All right, simple math, simple, right? So if our payout is that, and this is how much it costs us to get that many visitors, what we got to then do is we got to figure out how to get a lower cost. All right, so if we got probably, let's say, 45 cents a click, we'll be breaking even. Simple, right? Hope you guys understand that so far. If we're getting 45 cents a click, we're breaking even. If we're paying 50 cents a click, it's costing us more. All right, simple. All right, so initially, let's say we can basically do a stretch strategy that I tell a lot of people to do. Is to, let me erase something here. I'm gonna erase this right quick. All right, simple strategy, guys. Say bid low, budget high. All right, so what we're trying to do is get our CPC lower. There's multiple things that we can do to get our CPC lower. One thing is we can basically choose what keywords that is converting for us, stick with those keywords and try to be lower on them, or try to find cheaper keywords, or do this simple strategy right here. Bid low, all right, budget high. So let's say I bid low and say I took my bids from 50 cents a click all the way down to 35 cents. All right, so 35 cents is gonna cost me, simple math now, 35 cents is gonna cost me $350. All right, I don't know why I put that there, but it's gonna cost me $350. I come out making $100. Every time I spend $350, I make $450 revenue, and I make $100 profit. So I'm not in a exact loss here. Now what I would do with my budget, so let's say I'm spending $100 a day, right? What I would do is I would do something simple and try to go to like $400 a day. Okay? So instead of spending like $100 a day, I'm gonna try to spend at least like $400 a day. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna tell the algorithm, I'm gonna say, hey, basically what I wanna do is I wanna spend as much money as I can on a daily basis. Once I start spending a whole lot more money than I'm bidding this, then they're gonna have no choice but to give me that in return. So what I'm doing then is, let's say I change this to 25 cents, right? 25 cents bid low, right? 25 cents. I'm dropping the cost here to $250, right? And I'm coming out $200 of profit. All right, instead of spending $100, and let's say we spend let's say we up in our budget to, let's say, $600 a day, right? $600 a day, we're profiting that daily. That profit. So we spend, we're spending $250, bringing back $450 payout, and we're profiting $200 a day. So initially, when the conversion rate offer there, all right, take that. It costs, instead of 500, this is going to cost me 250, like this, right? So I hope you guys understand that strategy here. Simple, mad simple, nothing complicated about it whatsoever. I'm not trying to do anything, you know, to overcomplicate you guys today, right? Just hope you understand that strategy. Mad simple strategy. Yeah, all right. Second thing is understanding your numbers is probably like one of the major base things there. All right. One of the major base things that you got to know, and a lot of that stuff you can just ask your affiliate manager. We kind of get a good detail of exactly what it costs to get all these numbers there. All right, so back to the psychological part. That's the technical analysis part, all right? So I'm trying to think. When value, all right, you already know what I'm gonna say. When value exceeds price point, people buy every fucking time. Every fucking time. The value sees price point, people buy every fucking time. That's the truth. When people perceive something to be valuable, right, more than what they have in their own pocket, people is going to say, okay, I need that. Whatever I got to do, I need to trade for it. All right? So we should get started. And I'm going to give you a good demonstration. All right, let's say desire, right? Desire, thought. Dog costs, let's say, $1,000, right? All right, so the desire is a dog. Dog costs $1,000. Valuing that dog, the dog perceived the value. See value 5K. You have $1,000. You're gonna buy the dog, dog. It's just that something. That same psychological is the same thing that calls people to go through this funnel every single time and buy bullshit all damn day. Alright, second thing is initially is and also I'm looking at chat, so in case you guys have any questions and things that need. Second thing is creating value, all right? There's a lot of things that you have to do to create value, things of that nature that cause people to want to buy a part of a service that you're advertising over and over again. And that's a lot of the time it's not even mentioned here, all right? So let's say someone broke their wrist or something, or they, let's say someone broke their wrist or they want a laptop because that laptop is going to be working for them or something of that nature. A lot of people is going to be willing to spend, you know, whatever they got, do whatever they can get to get that laptop. Let's put it like this, you have a problem that you really want to get rid of. Let's say you got diabetes, right? You're sick and tired of insulin. You're sick and tired of going to the doctor. You're sick and tired of pain medications. You're sick and tired of all that bullshit, right? So you'll do whatever it takes to basically get off of diabetes, right? Of course. So what you can do is you sell upon the pain point of, you know, freeing them of that problem, all right? And what you do about that is you list out advantages. I promise you I can't spell for nothing today. Problems. Out advantages, your problems. You keep the message super simple. You ask questions. Alright. So a lot of this stuff, what I'm teaching right now, you can kind of use it against a fucking ClickBank product or something. Alright, so simple strategies, simple stuff like that, right? I'm about to show you how to do it. So, if you're on this call right now, and if you're watching the live stream right now, what I need you to do, go to ClickBank, pull up a fucking product, excuse my language, pull up a product, and think about what that product is targeting, what is the pain point of that product. That's what I want you to do. Like, what is the pain point of that product? Like, that's the main thing we have to do. What is causing you to, what is causing the people that product wants to buy? Like, what is it advertising? Just get rid of diabetes. The pain point is the person got diabetes. If it's toenail fungus, it's toenail fungus. It's how to fix computer. It's the pain point is they got a broke computer. All right, let's say it's virus removal. The pain point is their computer is just slow and it's full of viruses and they don't feel safe using their computer, right? Get that pain point initially, and that's what we got to emphasize. That's what we got to grow. But we have to do that in our own funnel. Alright? So that's what we have to do. We have to do that in our own funnel there. Okay? Also, again, I want you in the chat, if you guys have any questions, let me know ASAP here. Let's see if I want to understand. Alright. And also, as affiliate, being an affiliate is not really hard. It's really not hard whatsoever. A lot of people overcomplicate this thing, you know, and make it out to be more than what it actually is, and say, well, initially, well, I got to test, I got to continue doing this, I got to continue doing that, and things of that nature. But in reality, you don't actually have to do that. But a lot of people kind of emphasize those structures and those things like that and make people feel like, oh, it's all this technical analysis, it's all this technical analysis stuff. Really, in many cases, it's all mental. And if you can get past that mental barrier, you can kind of get past a lot of things when it comes to affiliate marketing. There. Not even just, you know, being as an affiliate, but actually owning your own products or promoting drop shipping or e-commerce or things of that nature. It's all about finding those pain points and understanding, seeing that there's a marketplace or something, is there supply and demand for a product or service. Once you understand that there's a product, a supply and demand for a particular product or service, it's easy to just like put something out there and just like shoot for it. But what you got to also do is you got to understand how to be unique in the marketplace and shoot for that angle right there. All right, that's another thing that I notice a lot of people does not angle for. So if everyone's on being ads, right, I'm going to kind of go through this very simply. If everyone's on being ads, I want you to think about this. Get it focused on the mindset set. Everyone's like saying, oh, I want to promote Venus Factor on being ads. I'm bidding on this keyword, I'm bidding on these six keywords, things that interest, this is what's working. First thing come to my mind is this. You know, obviously you thinking just like the majority of people. If you bid on the things that you got the most competition on, you know, it doesn't mean it's a bad thing. I mean, it works. So at the same time, you have a boatload of competition. So the Venus Profit Factor is a product about weight loss, right? And I'm bidding on, you know, the keyword, how to lose weight or something on Bing, right? Or Google, whatever. What I'm doing is I'm saying, well, I'm going to promote these people that can lose weight. I'm not going to win at anything because of the simple fact that I have so much competition going at me. And it's like I don't have any room to win. What I can do is I can say, okay, this is intent marketing, meaning that people is intentionally looking for it right then and there, all right? This is what got their attention. This is not interruption. This is direct, all right? So these people are actively looking or searching for a problem to their solution right then and there. Now, also get in the frame of mind that your product is not going to solve every problem. It's a big mistake a lot of people make. They think, well, oh man, if you get this entitled or you get that entitled, initially, you know, this it helps solve this issue, and then it helps solve that issue, and then it helps solve that issue. But in most case scenarios, it'll never do all those things at once. So what you got to think about is initially how you can specifically target a certain issue and go straight at that issue, not going at 150 issues. Like if you're shooting all your bullets at once, you're gonna run out of ammo. Now, if you're shooting one bullet at a time and you're focusing on that, then you're going to be 100% more precise and 100% more targeted with everything. That's the issue that I find that a lot of people does not understand when it comes to marketing and advertising. So they just shoot for the big, they never make it, they never hit a shot, never get any conversions, any sales, anything of that nature, and then it's like, oh, fuck the world. But in reality, you cannot be like that because you got to be a little bit more precise, all right? So when I say precise, let's say, you know, give you a great example. If a person is trying to promote the product Venus Factor, some weight loss product on Quickman, right? And we know that it's a weight loss product, we first need to determine exactly where else are those people. One thing that there is on Bing. Second thing, they could be on Google. Third thing, they could be on YouTube. Fourth thing, they could be on other social sites of that nature. But where is the mindset of those people when they're browsing that internet there? Yes, we can do cookie stuffing. Yes, we could be following them on, you know, various sites and retargeting and things of that nature. That's good, that's fine, that's cool. But at the same time, what is their intent when they click on that banner, all right? We know the demographics of people. Just because a person is fat and overweight doesn't mean they want to lose weight. Just saying, all right? Now, demographics is one thing, but we also got to get in the mind of them and say, okay, how can we promote this offer to build their trust at the same time and give them exactly a solution to their problem with instant gratification immediately as soon as they hit a page, and then also keep them on their page, keep them intentionally, keep their attention on that page for a long time, and also be able to present to them your offer of product or service, or pre-sell to them an idea, right? And make your product a service instead of your product or service being like the head-on thing you're promoting, let your product or service be initially, let's say, a part of the solution to their problem, all right? Kind of like what I showed you guys when I did the virus remover, that situation, right? Let it be a part of the solution to their problem. The product isn't their solution. Is part of solving the solution to your problem. You're overweight, you buy workout equipment, you know, the workout equipment is going to make you lose weight. The solution is you going out there and working on the workout equipment. That's going to solve your solution there. All right, so I want you to take in mind that it's more of a mental thing than, it's way more of a mental thing than it actually is a technical analysis type thing. And actually doing the mental part. So a lot of you guys is watching videos all the time, you know, watching people and things of that nature all the time. It's not very beneficial. You're wasting a lot of fucking time, to be honest with you. You're wasting so much time, you know, it's crazy. a lot of people be on the internet so much time. I've had people tell me they be on this thing trying to read books and watch take courses and stuff. And they spend like 10 hours a day just trying to study and trying to solve some type of fucking issue. And it's like depressing and sad to me, in my opinion. You know, but I would really say, you know, get more precise about what you do. Next video, I want you guys to check that out. Also, I'm going to be sharing that inside the group. I'm going to be going live in the group, and I'm going to go a little bit more in detail in the group there. Also, and be sure to check out the course. I have a link below in the description, or you can check out other videos on my channel. So just click that subscribe button. Look at other videos on my channel and get the course if you initially need it there. All right. See you guys soon in the future here.